rise and then you die for his glory. This is a true story. Sometimes you gotta live and fight, and then you die for his glory. This is a true story. Sometimes you gotta live and fight, and then you die for his glory. This is a true story. Sometimes you gotta live and fight, and then you die for his glory. Land of the free, home of the slave. It's all that's been shown to me. Not a lot has been given to me, but I'm here to fight for the land that you. L-O-V-E, it's a symbol of the pain that my ancestors came from. Growth with no education and nothing but economic exploitation. It's time to see what we are really made of. I'm a man of peace, I'm a man of mind, but I'm met with physical abuse and manipulation of the mind. The survival of the fittest in the streets is mine. Not by choice.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen.
Seeing the violence outside of my doorstep, wondering how can I escape this, knowing on the other side they trying to enslave us. This is a true story.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, you know what time it is. Let's get into a double eye greeting. It's a great day, ladies and gentlemen. Sometimes it gotta be this way.
It really does, but it should.
Let's go.
Showing tears.
I'm not with that back and forth. I'm the type to get to work.
I'm the type to keep
the go.
I'm the type to chase a bag. I'm the type to pop a tag.
New way, like
I have stars, ride around a fast car, rapping like my line bars. I do this all for my dogs. This is what it all costs when you gotta be the boss. If you not my dog,
I'ma have to cut you off.
I'ma have to cut you off. I'ma have to cut you off. If you not my dog. This is what it be like when I'm studying on my energy. This is what it be like when I make them feel my energy. Sitting on these raps, okay, you know what this really mean. This is what it's all about. I'm on top of everything. I'm the boss, don't play with me. This right here, no game with me.
Rock,
I'm making bread.
Oh, Trump supporters, this is the day.
Every day I wish you would. This is what it be like. You really on the come up. This is what it be
oh,
like.
Oh, Trump supporters, you know what time it is. We got, I got music for you. I got music for you. I got music for you today, ladies and gentlemen. Are we going to do something a little different? Hey, ain't no time, ladies and gentlemen.
Astronaut.
Ooh! Hey! Oh, there's some haters today. It ain't no time. Woo! Hey! It ain't no time, ladies and gentlemen. Into the lion's den. Yes, yes. Trump supporters, please get those knee pads ready. Because Jack Smith is coming. Oh boy, today is D-Day. Today is D-Day. or I Day. We'll call it I Day, okay? I stands for indictment, obviously. Indicated. You know what it means. Inclusive, whatever you want to call it. No games today, ladies and gentlemen. You know, I'm going to... Actually, you know what? I was going to turn that off, but I think I need to keep my television on just in case there is breaking news. When you say that, we need to keep our eyes and ears to these streets, ladies and gentlemen. You know, yesterday, I would like to, one, clear things up. Yesterday, I did get a little excited and a little passionate about everything that's going on. And to those who know me, I do apologize. Zeus did a little bit lose his cool. But you know what? I do have to push back. All right? I do have to push back because, listen, it's a dangerous world out here. And I'm a dangerous man. Okay? If I endorse anything, I will say I endorse it. If I don't endorse it, I don't endorse it. And I cannot control people in the comments, or I cannot control people in the box. And that goes for me, and that goes for Snuggles, and that goes for anybody else on this platform. You cannot control what other people say, okay? And that needs to stop immediately, ASAP. Really. You can't control what people say or do. I ask people to stop cursing, they don't stop cursing. All right, with that being said, yes, and two, wherever Paz is, Snuggles, tell Paz, you know. Zeus definitely, I was out of character yesterday when I singled him out, okay? Tell Paz I send him my best. But it does not stop me from bringing this heavy hammer of truth. And by the way, I think it's safe to say America right now. I hear my friends on the right saying America, they say other countries are laughing at us. This is what I heard my friends on the right say because Trump's getting indicted or he's about to be arraigned today. Other countries are laughing at us. I would like to go as far as to say they've been laughing at us. They've been laughing at us ever since Trump got into office. Welcome to the party. We have been sitting here trying to tell you day in and day out, this guy is bad for the United States of America. And yet and still, you continue to defend him all the way to this point. Trump supporters! When are you going to stop right in your tracks and realize he's a criminal? Probable cause? We have it. Evidence, we have it. 34 counts, we have it. We have the receipts. Alvin Bragg is probably going to go down. If we could do a Mount Rushmore, you know who we would put on there? Alvin Bragg. Yes, we would. We would put Fannie Willis. We would put Letitia James on this Mount Rushmore. And I definitely think you and I know who else we would put on there. Smack dab in the middle. Snuggles, if you're here, please say his name.
Jack Smith.
Woo, ladies and gentlemen. We would definitely put all of them on the Mount Rushmore of prosecutors who helped to save these lovely United States of America from what Trump has branded death and destruction. Yes, this is where we have arrived in these lovely United States of America. I personally do not think the rest of the world is laughing at the United States. They might be laughing at certain things that are happening in the United States, i.e. Trump getting indicted. I think that was funny. And for those of you who watched the plane take off yesterday and land in New York, you have to admit, that was kind of hilarious. I've never seen, and I've seen a lot of brothers go to jail. I've seen it go get arrested. I've seen it in my lifetime. Happens a lot. I have never seen anything so theatrical about going to face the judge. I mean, really? Really? You got to do all of this, Trump. You got to do all of these theatrical moments. You got to post all over your social media account. You gotta attack the prosecutor, and you gotta really try to turn this into the United States of America is going down in degradation, all because Trump himself got in trouble. I do not believe it. I do not buy it. And it's you know what my mother and father used to say? Playtime's over.
You know what? That's what this is. That's what this is to all my friends on the right, the ones that are still left. Playtime's over. It is now time for you to just start accepting what's really happening. This man is about to go into that court and look at that judge and see what exactly they have on him. And I have a high degree of confidence that once he goes into that courtroom today at 2:15, okay, once he goes into that courtroom at 2:15, I see your message, Snuggles. Don't worry, I'll bring you up first. Once he goes up into that courtroom and he faces those charges and they tell him what exactly he's been talked to about, what they wanted to see his rear end about, it's going to become crystal clear. His future in politics is over. The best he could do is be a cheerleader.
Greetings, Greg. Nice to see you. It doesn't stop there, ladies and gentlemen. I mean, look at this. TikTok, time's up. You know it. And I'm still going to say, Trump supporters, you do owe the United States of America an apology. You have to apologize to the United States of America, all citizens, Republicans and Democrats, for continuing to put this man on a pedestal, knowing all of the shame, all of the crimes that he's been involved with. He hasn't been convicted yet. I get that. We and Snuggles have a bet still. Now the bet is moved from he won't be indicted to, you know, he won't be convicted. I have news for you, Snuggles, and everyone else. Just like I told you, there wasn't going to be a red wave, remember? And I went to Arizona and I did the Lord's work in Arizona. You saw me eating, you saw me smiling and having a great time. Thank you, Angela. And I told you there won't be a red wave. You didn't believe me. But guess what? There wasn't a red wave. I went. Okay, and I told you, maybe I got the dates wrong, but I said, he's going to get indicted. You said, Zeus, that won't happen. It'll never happen. He's been indicted. And he's on his way to getting indicted again and again and again. Trust me when I tell you this. He's going to get convicted.
Order!
Look at this, ladies and gentlemen. There's no strings attached. I am not a hand puppet. No one is paying me to tell you this. This is simply because of my loyalty and my allegiance to the truth. That's all. I don't want you to end up in this situation that you're currently in. And the situation that you're currently in right now is you're scrambling. You're scrambling right now because you don't know what to do next. I don't know what to do now once those handcuffs get put on, okay? And I'll just say this. If you follow the history of the United States of America, anyone has ever been the target of justice, they didn't survive. You got to go through the process. No matter who you are, no matter what corner of the earth you're on, it's a very difficult thing to escape the United States saying, this particular person, we need them because they owe us justice. And this is where Trump has seemed to have found himself. And it's not because of anyone other than himself. And I want you to understand that. You're making your lives a lot harder by continuing to align yourself next to a criminal. And this is why you're struggling. This is why you're frustrated. Okay? Instead of saying, you know what? I got it wrong. And we all have got it wrong at a certain point in our lives. No one here is above reproach. Okay? We all have gotten it wrong. Instead of saying that, you're still holding out hope. You're still deflected. I go to your lives. You know what they want to talk about? They want to talk about Second Amendment rights right now. They want to talk about women's reproductive rights right now. They want to talk about Biden. They want to talk about infrastructure. I don't want to talk about it right now. I want to talk about this so-called, it's taken 7 years to get them and nothing. You've never gotten them on anything. Well, TikTok, time's up. It's time to talk about this and this only, okay? And that's what I do. That's why I do what I do. You know, and if you think what I say is ridiculous,
If you think what Zeus says is ridiculous. No, it's not just Trump. It's also his attorneys. It's also the people in Trump orbit. It's the same. It's a shame. It's a shame that I have to cover things like this. Tupac's sister has to call out Donald Trump's attorney for comparing him to Tupac. Uh-oh, look at that. Let me bring that back. Let me make sure it's sitting there, ladies and gentlemen. Hold on. Hold on. There it is. Uh-oh, they tried to steal it, but I'm bringing it back. Tupac's sister has to call out Donald Trump's attorney for comparing Trump to Tupac. Wow. Just shame! Order, please! The late, great Tupac Shakur. This is why they compare Trump to Jesus. They compare Trump to other martyrs. They compare him to Martin Luther King. Malcolm X. Now he's Tupac. Now he's a thug. Now he's... What part of Tupac are you trying to compare Trump to? And you act as if others out here in the real world don't know who Tupac Shakur is and what he stood for and what he represented. You act like when you do these things, you don't cause harm to him and his family. And then when we call you out and say, hey, what you're doing is wrong. When we say that, you tell us we're tripping. I call that an abusive relationship. You ever been in an abusive relationship where they accuse you of cheating, and then you later find out it's them who were cheating? You know, it's one of those kind of relationships with the Trump and his supporters sometimes. Because the reality is this. Trump supporters do call Democrats names. Trump supporters do lie and make up stuff too. It ain't just the Democrats. And I just call it straight down the middle like I see it. And if it's wrong, it's wrong. I don't think anyone should be calling each other names. But this narrative that it's just the Democrats, no, it's not. It's you as well. This narrative, it's the radical left. No, it's not. There are other Republicans that don't want Trump in office. And I keep having to repeat this message, and I hope it rings true to some of you out here. Okay, look at this. This is what his attorney, Hababa, or whatever her name is, she says Donald Trump is Tupac. Donald Trump is Biggie Smalls. But no, Donald Trump is his own brand. He is everything. This is just going to boost him. We have seen it in the polls. This is not a question. This is a fact. Okay, and it's a shame this actually has to happen. Okay? And listen, those comments did not sit right with many on social media, including Tupac's sister, Seth Shakur. She labeled the comment to TMZ as blasphemous! Blasphemy! Why would Trump's attorney say such things? Because she had to emphasize that Tupac was actually a man measured by his integrity, principles, and personal and collective responsibility. Shakur added that Tupac himself held himself accountable for his 1994 sexual abuse trial, and Trump isn't doing the same thing. Shame! It's these kind of outrageous statements that gives me the energy I need to wake up day in and day out and deliver this message to my friends on the right. For the life of me, for the love of God, please cut it out. Trump is not Tupac. Don't ever say that again. Very disrespectful, very disingenuous, and you and I know it. And it's a shame that I have to address these things. Moving along, speaking of Trump's attorneys, and I'm going to open up the box, okay? I'm going to open up the box. Get this. They don't like me because I tell the truth, and that's fine. But, you know, the truth will set you free. And what I've learned over the course of my time on this platform is eventually these folks that are my biggest critics turn around and become probably my strongest allies. It just takes a while. It just takes a while for them to realize what I'm doing and what I'm saying. Maybe it's the delivery, how I'm saying it, you know. I don't like how he sounds when he says it, but man, that stuff is rolling around in my head. And you know what? Maybe there's some truth to what Zeus is saying. Maybe there's some truth to what some of his friends have been saying to me. It isn't what I think it is. It's these other things as well. You know, this is why I encourage people that brand themselves to be intelligent to stop thinking of yourself as intelligent and as the smartest person on the planet, because even the smartest person on the planet can be humbled. Okay, and that's called life. Ha!
All right, breaking, a call to activism has filed an official ethics complaint in Colorado Supreme Court office regulations against another Trump attorney, Jenna Ellis. And there's the case number. Snuggles, if you're here, go ahead and look up the case number. I know you love those case numbers, okay?
I did this for you, Snuggles. When I came across this, I wanted to make sure. You got the case number. And if let me read it to you. Case number 23-1193 will seek her disbarment. Now, why do we need to disbar this attorney of Trump's again? Well, it turns out on March 31st, Jenna Ellis, you know she's already been caught admitting she lied. Okay, well, she's at it again. She shocked legal experts by calling on Trump to refuse to surrender to New York and asking DeSantis to help avoid extradition. Really? Really? So we don't have any respect for law. You don't want to respect the laws. You want the Democrats to follow the rules. You want the Democrats to obey the laws, but you don't want Trump to obey the law. It doesn't make sense. However, listen, these people are on top of it. They are saying this is a direct violation of Colorado's rule of professional conduct for attorneys in Colorado. Specifically, rule 8.4 against misconduct. We have to stop the misconduct, the misinformation, the lies, and conspiracies if we really want to make America great again, whatever that means. And I have made it a promise to myself to make sure that if I spot it, I'ma address it in that moment. There's nothing more that grinds my gears. There's nothing that grinds my gears more than misinformation. I think misinformation is the worst thing that we have going on in this United States of America. It's truly what I think the worst, most toxic, evil, vile thing out here. I you know, I could be wrong. You know, some could say it's the Second Amendment, the First Amendment. It's misinformation. With misinformation, I'll tell you what misinformation does. It'll cause couples in love, right? Sometimes you might think your partner's cheating on you. Someone could whisper in your ear and spread misinformation, and it could cause something very terrible to happen. Things like that. That's why I say lying and misinformation is probably the worst thing we got going on in this country, ladies and gentlemen. So, as you can tell, and I think there's more to this story. Let me double check. Uh-huh. Okay. Here we go. Yes, Jenna Ellis. They said lawyers should not publicly call for crimes to be committed. Okay, and we are determined to start making our laws work in this country. Ellis has been disciplined before and has learned absolutely nothing. It is time to hold her accountable. Trump supporters, that's what we're about over here. Yeah, I might joke around. I might tell jokes back and forth, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, okay. But like my grandmother used to tell me, don't let the smooth taste fool you, okay? I might laugh and joke, but I'm no one to play around with. Think I got here on TikTok being a fool, do you? Really? Do you really think I got here on TikTok day in and day out sitting on this camera? You think I got here by being a fool? You might want to think twice and think to yourself, perhaps there is something to what Zeus is saying. Perhaps this guy, maybe he does know a little something. Okay, because not everybody is as blessed as I am to do this. Not, I mean, you're blessed too. You're blessed too. But you know what I'm saying? Think about it. What does it take to keep Zeus on TikTok? Because he sounds like a pretty interesting kind of guy, right?
All right, ladies and gentlemen. Today, Trump is going to get indicted. Okay, he's going to get arraigned. And we need to talk about it as a nation. Because listen, if we don't talk about it, I understand there won't be any healing. Okay, and what I'm hoping that we can do is get to a place of healing.
through all of this. But it cannot happen as long as we continue to allow lies and misinformation to be spread, okay? And I'm willing to hear from all of you today, okay? Because that's what this is about. And I will be doing extensive coverage, okay? I really will. Hello, April. Nice to see you. By the way, ladies and gentlemen, please follow my good friend, April, okay? She hosts a lot of great lives. I'm not as patient. I'm too direct. But if you go there, you definitely will hear the truth nonetheless. Okay, let's open up the box. All right. We can talk today. I'm not talking about nothing other than Donald Trump getting indicted. I get there's a lot going on out here. But the show must go on. The show must go on, ladies and gentlemen. Now, I did tell Snuggles I would talk to him first, and then we'll go in order. Kiss my bacon. I don't know how I like you next to me like that, Snuggles.
Hello. How you doing?
I'm doing all right. How are you doing?
That was a beautiful opening. I just want to let everybody know that I'm going to be going live later on today. I'm just going to show the plane ride going back home. He's got his Trump rally tonight. He's running for president of the United States tonight at his Trump rally 2024. He's just going to stop in for this little traffic ticket and go back home. And that is it. What are we talking about now? What would you like to discuss with me today?
How are you going to deal with this whole Trump being arraigned thing? I'm concerned. I really am concerned.
It's just a little court appearance, not guilty. Go home. That's about it. We got a Trump rally to focus on. Listen, the president of the United States, he's got to focus on the future here. We got a lot of stuff going on around the world, which we won't discuss right now because you guys are focusing on a little traffic ticket. It's just a bumper to bumper. You know what I'm saying? If you know what I mean.
Yeah.
All right.
You sound like you're in a great mood.
I'm in a great mood. We got a presidential election in a year. We've got a few little court cases here, just simple things that Americans go through on an everyday process.
Yeah.
Let's just get through this. He looks great. He's going to go into court, not guilty. Hop at that plane. I'm going to show him the plane ride home because you showed the plane ride yesterday's live. It was great. Today I'm going to show the plane ride back, okay, because that's the real thing. Going back home, getting ready for the next president of the United States. I can't wait till they ask for the case to be dismissed on that leak, whoever leaked those 34 indictments. I'm so excited for that dismissal and the court to say, the judge to say, you know what, let's dismiss this case.
Well, you know
you guys
what?
You guys got your perp walk and a pitcher. Democrats need a little something to feel good about themselves.
Will you promise to maintain this energy, this enthusiasm throughout the rest of the day?
Oh, absolutely. I'm in a great mood. I can't wait to his rally tonight.
You're good. Okay. The reason I'm
That gag order is for Stormy Daniels. That gag order is for Stormy Daniels. We don't want her to gag on anything. All right.
Snuggles.
What?
The reason I'm asking you, will you promise to maintain this enthusiasm?
Oh, yes.
Because there's going to be a party on TikTok today. I might be in that party, and you're more than welcome to come.
Oh, yes. I will come to your party, and as well, I'd like you to come to my party tonight for the Trump rally party. I must warn you, though.
So Trump is going to, be processed at 2:15 p.m. Eastern time.
Yeah. What time is that Central time? I don't care about the process. He's just going to say not guilty and go home. I don't know what the deal is. He'll be there.
That'll be 11 o'clock my time.
Okay.
Also,
so probably 1 p.m.
I think you should also, allow the margin of possible error in your world where
beautiful. I want to wish Keely a happy birthday. Can you do a happy birthday song for Keely?
It's her birthday today.
Happy birthday to Keely.
Keely, are you there? Happy birthday. If it's her birthday,
happy birthday.
I'll sing happy birthday to you after the live, that's for sure. I do that to all my friends.
So
I want to get back to what I needed to talk to you about, and then I got to go to the next guest. Okay,
please. Definitely.
You're more than welcome to send a guest request up after I go through all the guests, because sometimes all of you want to talk. I get it. Okay, it is your birthday. I got you. The question I wanted to ask you is, when you see all 34 of those charges for yourself, will you still promise to be happy? Because I'm concerned that once you see what they're charging him with, you might go down and you might get sad again.
Right, right. No. We are moving forward. I'm very excited. I'm very excited. He's not going to say not guilty 34 times. It's just going to be one time. Okay. So, I'm excited to it. I'm really excited. We're going to move forward here. Tonight's rally. Guys, tune in to tonight's Trump rally. It's excellent. President of the United States. Lots of issues across this world that we have to deal with instead of you guys. This is your breaking news and your top story. You enjoy your pick of Donald Trump, his fingerprinting, and his walkthrough. That's for you guys. But at the end of the day, Trump will again, like two acquittals. He will go ahead with this and get a not guilty. So enjoy this moment. And then I hope that one more question.
You have a call.
Yeah, I'm not open yet. One more question for you. Would you and your Democratic friends accept the fact that when he's found not guilty and I eat my steaks, will you finally get over this? And when he becomes president of the United States, will you finally just say, hey, maybe I should just take a step back and relax?
If the possibility of that happening is slim to none. But if it does
happen,
that does happen, I can only speak
just
for
like
myself.
The impeachments.
If that does happen, I can only speak for myself, and I will definitely. I will definitely be in awe. But I want you to know this, Snuggles, before you leave.
Yeah.
I told you there wasn't going to be a red wave, and I was right. And I told you Trump was going to be indicted, and I was right.
Right.
And I'm going to
say.
I'm going to say
James
this.
Comey.
No. And the last thing I'm going to tell you, I'm right about. He will be convicted. And that's a fact.
No, he won't.
Yes. Now.
Can you say, I'm going to give you steaks? Can you say that to me? I'm going to give you steaks. You're going to, right?
I got to win. Reading Poker Dad, yes, I am splitting the Red Sea. By the way, Snuggles, Poker Dad and I have been.
You know what kind of Red Sea? You know what kind of Red Sea you're splitting? It's my ketchup for my two steaks.
Mr.
Poker Dad.
The Red Sea, because
the ketchup.
No.
The ketchup for my steaks.
No. I'm splitting the Red Sea.
That's when Poker says that he's on my side a little bit.
Order, Snuggles. I am splitting the Red Sea because guess what?
Yes.
I have found that my beliefs right now are almost overlap. They pretty much overlap with Republicans against
Trump. I know,
Trump.
Christina.
All right.
Yeah.
So Republicans against Trump, please unite in the
I know ketchup on steaks is horrible. I know, but it's just the way Chicago people eat it. We like ketchup on our steaks. Okay, so let's split the Red Sea. We got it going. Hey, listen, Zeus, I love you, my friend. And no matter what in life, politics is 5%. Living our lives is 95%. Let's live it. Let's love it. Let's get through this entertainment. And again, it's going to be a not guilty today and no conviction later down the road. And Trump will be president 2024, guaranteed. Let's go.
All right. You got to
watch your live. And hello to everybody as well.
Well, I like that you're in a better mood today. And
I'm in a great mood.
I want to keep that. Thank you, Moonshine. All right. I got to move it on, Snuggles. You know how we do.
Go ahead.
Thank you so much.
Democrats, get your.
I got him. Shame on you. Trying to use Zeus's lines. Cut it out, Snuggles. Thank you, April. Greetings, Nutty Professor.
So hello. I'm going to be very brief. Very very good to see you, my friend. And I question the people you have put into your corner that puts ketchup on steaks. That's all I'm going to say on that. That's all I'm going to say on that.
He's out of his mind.
And I got to tell you, that is not
Forget
a
about it.
Chicago.
He knows not what he does.
That is not a Chicago thing. Don't disparage Chicago in that manner, sir. So anyway, so I want to ask a question. I want to ask a question. When has America ever been great?
I don't have an answer for that.
Because when we say make America great again, that says that at one point in time, it was great. Now, America has always had the potential of greatness, and we still have that potential of greatness.
Someone said at
So,
2:15 p.m. Eastern time.
yeah, okay, that's good. That's good. So here's what I wanted to announce to you. I'm waiting on the decision of my university,
Oh.
to see if I can go live on TikTok.
Oh.
Because I'll be teaching at 1 o'clock Central
Oh.
Time. I'll be
Oh.
teaching my constitutional law class.
Oh.
And so I've asked to go live on TikTok because we're going to be discussing this, because this is constitutional,
Yeah.
what we're discussing.
Right.
So I have to get permission to go live. I'm still waiting on that decision. I will text you, let you know if that's a affirmative. Because if it is, I want TikTok to come to my live, to see the reaction of the students that I'm teaching. And we're gonna have some good discourse, because I have a mixed group of students that I teach. I have Democrats, Republicans, Independents, but they have their
I
own
love it.
mind. And so we're gonna see where they stand after this and after he's arrested, because the indictment equals to arrest. Okay, so we're gonna see. So hopefully I'll be able to go live. They're not really buying what I sold, but hope they didn't say no, so we'll just wait for their final decision.
Okay, well, I mean, I think it's awesome that you're at least making an effort and you're not just bypassing the rules. You're
Yeah.
showing your students that, you know what? As passionate as I am about this, I still got to double check with the administrators here at the
Oh, absolutely.
school to
Listen,
make sure
man.
I can go live. That's what this is all about, ladies and gentlemen. You got to follow the rules.
I'm not gonna bite the hands that hand that feeds me. I ain't
Nope.
crazy. I am not crazy. And I'm not Trump. I'm not a grifter. I'm not gonna lose my job and then say, please give me money.
Well, I did like that Trump did say, if you're not doing good, don't send me any money. But if you are doing good because of, his policies, then go ahead and empty out your bank account. It made me realize that, you know what? I think reality is starting to set in for Trump.
Well, we'll see. But I'm gonna drop down. But Mama Cat, she asked, what does that have to do with constitutional law? Ma'am, if you have to ask that question, then you probably need to sit in my class.
Well,
That's the way
send her
I'll
an
answer that.
invite. Send
That's why.
her an invite.
Like, if she doesn't know why this is part of constitutional law, she probably needs to come sit in my class or go to a basic government course. So thank you. Have a great day. And today is a national holiday. It's indictment day. But one more thing. I do want to give deference and honor to the late Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Today marks the 55th year of his unaliving. So I do want to bring that, because throughout all the things that's going on today, let us not forget a true civil rights leader who was gunned down on this day 55 years ago.
Wow, yeah. Wow, thank you.
So,
And Nutty, I do like that Jack Smith picture you
yeah,
have.
he's a quite handsome gentleman, isn't he?
Oh, he is definitely is a handsome and scary individual, just like Zeus.
Well, I knew you were going to say that. I'm not going to do it today. Zeus, I'm not going to do it today. I'm going to let you have this one, my friend. I'm going to let you have this one. So, I'm not going to attack your Triple H theory today. I'll reserve that tomorrow. So I yield back the balance of my time.
Yes,
Thank
I am
you,
humble.
sir.
Thank you, Nutty Professor. Okay, and then
Thank
I'm
you,
going
sir.
to.
Have a great day.
All right, you as well. We bring up our next guest, Double I. Greetings.
Good morning, Zeus, and
good morning, everybody. How are you?
Doing excellent.
All right. How are you holding up out there?
I'm doing great. I watched a great series yesterday of a plane taking off and landing, and that was very theatrical and dramatic, and I loved it, every bit of it.
You did?
What plane was this? I think it was a Trump plane. I think it was.
Woo! Did you see him get off of that airplane? I've been watching it over and over.
I saw him get off, and I just have this one thing to say. So I woke up this morning, and I like to look a little bit of coverage of what's going on, and it's very interesting of who Donald Trump has on his legal team now to support him in Manhattan. I encourage everybody to go look at his legal team. When I tell you it's a Barnum and Bailey circus, it's a circus like no other. So I did have reservations that he was going to be convicted. I was a little unsure because, you know, typically America does not hold certain people accountable, wink, wink.
Right.
But looking at his legal counsel that he's assembled that has a bunch of clowns and personal interests amongst lawyers in there suing each other, oh, we're going to get that conviction in my book now.
I mean, here is my opinion about this. One, I don't think they would move forward with this case if they didn't have a very strong case. That's my opinion. Number two, in every case that I've seen convictions happen in, it really doesn't matter what kind of legal defense most people have. It really matters what kind of evidence, right? Evidence speaks for itself. And that could be whether it's video footage, audio recordings, written records, or witness testimony. It's usually those things. And I don't think a lot of people who think of themselves as legal scholars, experts in law, I don't think they understand this. What's being said on TV and social media is nowhere near what is really happening in that courtroom. And so that's why I think there's going to be a conviction, not just with this case, but all people brave enough to have decided to move forward with criminal charges against the former president. I think they have checked off all of those boxes when it comes to evidence.
And I'll say this last piece and I'll drop down. I personally do not feel sorry for any lawyer that has supported Donald Trump, past, present, or in the future, that might be facing disembarkment. I'm sorry. I don't. You at some point, you have to have standards. You can't keep supporting criminals when the person that you're supporting will throw you under the bus in a heartbeat.
Yeah. So, you're absolutely right.
Look at
all of his lawyers. This new one, Joe Tacopino, he's taking a back seat now. He did that media circus. Now he's taking a back seat because Trump got another lawyer. Michael Cohen, look at him. Not there. Look at Jenna Ellis. Look at him. They go as far as they can go, and then they end up having to take a back seat because they get in trouble. It's not a good. And even the ones that Jack Smith has talked to. It's over. You can't defend someone who makes it easy to convict. I'm sorry.
So I'll say this again as I head out. I have just a little bit more faith in our legal system today. I will say that.
Yeah, I do too. I do too. And thank you, Double I, for bringing that honesty to TikTok once again. Thank you so much. Listen, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, Cochran and Christina Bob. Yes, Angela. All of them, they don't have a leg to stand on at this point. Trust me. Oh, we're going to bring up Shay. Good morning, Shay. How are you doing?
Fantastic. How's everybody this morning?
Oh, we are doing so well.
I tell you, we got a little step in our step. Yes, we do. Yes, we do. Yes, we do.
Yes. Yes, how are you holding up over there?
You know, I'm doing good. I'm doing good. You know, tick-tock, you know.
Hey!
A few more hours here, but that's all right. Yeah, there was something that came out that is a possibility of 34 felonies.
34 felonies?
That's what we're hearing through the grapevine. Wow. We will find out. We will find out. Like,
wow.
I just really advise all of you that have believed that this is a witch hunt, that this is misdemeanors, that this is a speeding ticket or parking ticket, whatever Jimmy said, ridiculous stuff. Just prepare yourself. This is going to be serious. And I do believe that the judge will put a gag order on him.
You think so?
I saw
Don Jr. He was having a meltdown about that gag order.
Oh, absolutely. But if you think about it, and listen, this is where I'm just going to say this, and you Trumpies might be shocked, but honestly, to benefit President Trump, he needs to be gagged. I mean, honestly, to keep him from making his situation worse.
If you love him, if
you really care about him and you want him to be able to run again, which I really think you need to give that up. But regardless, this is a whole different thing. And you guys in the impeachment thing was not a criminal, guys. That was a political constitutional right of the House of Representatives to impeach him. So because the senators did not have the guts to acquit or indict him or remove him, that's a whole separate thing that had nothing to do with DOJ, had nothing to do with anything else. That was completely a constitutional political thing. So separate out the fact that he got away with the two impeachments and not removed from office from what is going on today. This is hyper serious. This, if he runs his mouth and fights against the gag order, he can literally be put in prison. He can be held in contempt of court. This is serious. This isn't something to be joking about. This isn't something to be playing off. This isn't the same as what happened when he was president. This is serious. So I hope that for his benefit, I know this is shocking you, but for his benefit, he has issued a gag order because he will only make his situation worse if he continues to talk about this case, threatening the DA and all of these things. So he needs to hush. He really does.
He really does. Mm-hmm. And I'm glad that you pointed that mm-hmm. out, Shay, because I don't really think they understand that.
Mm-mm.
They're making it harder for Trump with their blind loyalty, yeah. their allegiance to him, and not really understanding how law works in this country.
Yeah. Yeah.
You have to stop getting emotional about what's happening and help him in other ways. I have a lot of respect, and I have a lot of friends that are actually, you know, they say they support Trump. But they do say we need to, you know, be a little more strategic about how we handle this, because this is serious. They don't go along with the narratives that are out here that this is a witch hunt.
Right. Exactly. They don't, you know, and especially when we get to read the indictments and you see how serious this is. The case isn't getting dismissed. None of that is happening. And if
right.
it's a bunch of felonies, he's not going to win on appeal. I think this is coming down to be a lot more serious than what we originally all of us were worried about this, right? We were worried
right.
that we're not going to have the meat, right? And therefore, don't waste our time. And we don't want a political witch hunt on him. If he broke the law, we want solid proof and we want to know everything about it. And he is innocent until proven guilty. He needs to stand up and try to prove his innocence. He needs to have his day in court. He needs to be treated fairly, 100%. I think we all feel that way. But you guys have got to stop sniffing after him and try to get him to understand that, and you need to understand how serious this is so you don't lose your shit, attack people, and lose your constitutional rights, because then you're charged with something.
So, exactly.
You know, and this is just the bottom truth, guys. I hate to bring the truth. I know we all are laughing and we're enjoying our day. If the shoe was on the other foot, y'all be doing the same thing, right? So let's be honest, but this is where we've got to be serious about this and saying this is the first time outside of Spiro Agnew and a lot of that where, you know, we had a vice president that was convicted of felonies under the Nixon administration. There have been things like this. John Edwards was another one. So, you know, this has happened before, guys. And so this is good for the country and for the world to see that we hold our political and past and future presidents not above the law. And this is so important to understand this, guys, as we move forward.
Amen.
Right? So, yes, we're going to party today because we've been trying to tell you guys for 8 years, this is not a man that we want in office. This is not, he does not have the character to withhold all that kind of power and not get himself in trouble. He just doesn't.
And no one is above the law. No. I've been saying that since I got on this whole thing about politics. No one is above the law.
No. Nope. Okay. No.
And we don't want to see him do it. We don't want to see you do it.
Exactly. We would hold all the same. So stop with the what about Clinton and the you know what? This is, again, this is not anywhere comparable to anything that you guys think the Clintons and that the Obamas did. It just isn't.
Nope.
And I think you'll see that today. So I'm just trying to prepare you a little bit. So
I'm prepared. I am prepared to watch this all unfold on the media and give my provide my 2 cents. Mm-hmm. Okay. And that's what this is about. Okay. Yeah. We saw it with OJ.
Yes.
And now we're seeing it with Trump, the former president of these lovely United States of America. I mean, did he really think he wouldn't get caught?
That's what I'm, Well, yeah, I think he did. I think, you know, you have to remember that Trump has been avoiding and getting away with so much of this for years.
Years.
And he has tactics that has been working for him up until now. You know, and I think, and you guys need to stop talking, but the whole thing about Bill Barr and Vance, that was a whole thing. Bill Barr told Vance not to proceed with this after
right.
convicted. That's what happened to that. So that was Trump's DOJ interfering in the further investigation on Trump on the Stormy Daniels issues. Cohen was thrown under the bus and into prison, but then Barr stopped, Cy Vance was his name? Vance from continuing this, and Bragg picked this up from that point. So just kind of trying to keep you guys up to what actually happened in 2018, you know? And the thing with Stormy Daniels and the gag, she ended up having to pay Trump because she did break the gag order. So, yeah.
And that's a shame. That's a shame that she had to pay Trump.
Mm-hmm.
What? But you know what? Thank you, Stormy Daniels, for giving him a refund and interest. Thank you.
Right? That's what I was
saying. It was worth it. You know what? Because I'm pretty sure taking his money and his time was probably the worst time you've ever experienced in your lifetime. This is definitely by far the worst thing I've ever seen happen. How do you pay somebody to be silent and they do the exact opposite and pay you your money back? Wow. You cannot make this stuff up.
And look what Kemp is trying to do. Look at what the politics is being played in Georgia. Kemp is trying to silence Fannie Willis. I mean, she got a grand jury which is a jury of your peers, guys. You need to look up what a grand jury is. It's 12 to 23 people of your peers basically making the decision. And the reason they do that is because they don't want a judge who could be very political making decisions, right? So they get a grand jury, which is just citizens right out of the area, to see all the information, determine everything, and then they make the decision. Therefore, it removes the political aspect of indictments. That's why they use grand juries on things like this. So,
Interesting.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much, Shay.
Woo-hoo. We will be staying and partying later. Let's go. Let's go.
Hey. Thank you so much, Shay.
Thank
Snuggles,
you.
I don't know why you keep saying I blocked you. I haven't blocked you.
No. All right.
No one's blocking. Yes. Right. Thank you, Shay. I am going to move
on. Okay. Bye.
Bye-bye. Look at this, ladies and gentlemen. We are getting closer and closer to those indictments. Oh my goodness. Oh my gosh. We are back in the thick of things. Happy Accountability Indictment Day. Attacking, how are you doing this morning?
Good morning. It's a sad day.
Oh.
It's a sad day that we have to go through this with a president who lied and conned his way through life and into the presidency and deluded the minds of millions of people that only he is the right person to follow in every way, shape, and form. You had a person up here who said that what's happening right now is something that every American has done.
In regards, what do you mean by that?
I'm gonna lay it out. Oh. Snuggles, talking about the court cases, said it's nothing no American hasn't done. Okay, so you remember when Donald Trump says he loves the uneducated?
Yes.
You have people who follow Trump who willingly lie for him, who willingly spew his lies for him, listen to only his lies, don't follow truth and facts and documentation because Trump never provides anything. They're willing to support a man and wave a flag. This is how fake they are. They don't wave Donald Trump's flag of his own body and face. They wave a flag with Sylvester Stallone's body and his head. So everything in regards to Donald Trump is fake, and his followers follow that same pattern. Everything is fake. Everything is a lie. Now, Trump followers say that he's just like them. And again, going back to a comment from Snuggles. So does that mean that people like Snuggles are willing to SA women? If he's just like you, are you willing to do that? Are you somebody who steals documents? Are you somebody who willingly lies about things that you've done to other people? So for people who follow Trump, say he's just like us, that means you're a liar, a con man, and an essayer.
I don't think that's what they mean when they say
he's... I'll see you now. Don't give him shade because they're saying he's just like them. Don't critique that portion. If he's just like them, they are following his footsteps, his words, his lies. They're willing to donate to a billionaire knowing that he's a billionaire as they struggle to make ends meet. They are willing to throw out the rule of law because they support one guy who teases them with lies and the smell of a steak when it's really poisoned liver. They're willing to toss out the rule of law with all the documentation that is being brought forth in depositions, court transcripts, phone calls, text messages, and they're willing to say Hillary Clinton, Joe Biden, and Barack Obama are criminals and should be locked up without 1 ounce of evidence. They're willing to tear the fabric of democracy in the United States of America for a guy that teases their taint and is lying to them as their...
What if some were to say that perhaps your critique is a bit too harsh and really inaccurate about what they really believe? Perhaps they just might believe he's the best president for the United States.
Boo-hoo. Boo-hoo.
That's what they mean.
No, I'm saying boo-hoo. Cry baby, do you need a cry and tell? Do they need a cry and tell? Everything Donald Trump has said to them, they've lied. He's lied to them. He didn't give them an infrastructure, didn't give them a new health care plan, didn't give them better policies.
Well, that's the Democrats' fault.
Yes, of course it is. Just like Donald Trump does. Just like Donald Trump does, he points at everybody else. It's not his fault. It's not his fault. It's everybody else's fault. Just like what they're doing right now. They're saying this is a witch hunt. They don't care about the facts. They don't care that Michael Cohen went to prison for covering for Donald Trump's money laundering. They don't care that his CEO went to prison in Rikers Island, 17 charges against Trump Organization. They don't care that he wrote out multiple checks to Michael Cohen. They don't care that he paid more taxes to China than the United States.
He's an outsider. He's not a politician attacking. Come on.
Oh, another Trump, another Trump quote. Oh, poor baby.
How was he supposed to know he was breaking the law when he made that arrangement with an attorney that we found out was corrupt?
Ignorance of the law is no excuse.
Mm.
Isn't that what they say?
They do say that.
They do say that. But the thing is this. We, you, I, produce documents just like you did with Jenna Ellis.
Mm.
A document.
Case numbers.
A case number.
I had a case number today.
But what do other people show? A 5-year-old video of Pam Bondi. No documentation in regards to
documentation
to Ukraine.
No Yazzie.
You know, thing is this.
Mm.
They're willing to for one man destroy the fabric of America because he makes them feel good, not with truth, not with evidence,
right?
With lies.
Mm.
You are willing to donate and tear America apart for lies. You don't even have any substance to grab onto.
Mm.
It's like Casper the ghost. You think he's there, but you can't touch him or feel him. It's
right. Just... I hear you. Well,
but the thing is this.
Mm-hmm.
It is a horrible day. It's a horrible day that one man's egotistical attitude and ability to not take responsibility for what he has done has brought this to what it is right now. Mm-hmm. He, on Hannity, said, I have the right to take documents if I want them. They're my documents. I get to see them.
Now, stop right there, attacking. When it comes to those classified documents, that is a good point. He does not have the right to those documents. He did not declassify those documents. When the government says give it back, they mean give it back. Because if you don't give them back, then you will meet Jack. Hey, that rhymed, didn't it? Jack Smith. This is why we are doing this. Because you didn't do it. Do you think his supporters could have prevented all of this? Do you think Trump's supporters could have prevented him from going to these extremes? I think they could have. I think that if they would have convicted him when he got impeached, I think we wouldn't be in this spot right now.
Exactly. Hey, Gator, I don't have a heart. I used to be a car salesman when I was younger.
Oh. Now listen, attacking. Thank you so much. I got to move on.
Hold on. I'm not done.
Well, how much more time do you got? Listen, there's a couple more
Give me 30 seconds.
That's what she said, but continue.
I gave her 15.
I'm getting in trouble.
For you guys to continue to support Donald Trump, knowing the evidence is in front of you, you need to take a look in the mirror and see what you're really doing, not only to others, but to yourself. You're willing to throw away your ethics, your morals, your common sense, your family values for one man who doesn't give anything, care one ounce about you. You're willing to destroy America for a guy who wouldn't put you out if you were on fire.
Mm.
I'm sorry, guys. This is tearing America apart. When is enough enough? And by the way, once you start showing evidence, we'll start listening to you and taking you serious. But you guys are a joke. You are deplorables. You are the small percentage that Hillary Clinton said are deplorable. That's exactly.
Do you think we'll ever get away from the name calling and the rhetoric in this country? Do you think we'll ever get to a point where neither side is calling each other names?
Yeah, I do. After Trump is gone, yeah. I mean, there will always be some type of shots at each other, but I think it won't be as despicable as it's been under Trump and what he's given the license for people to hate, to hate gays, to hate blacks, to hate Muslims, to hate Chinese, to hate everybody who's not a white Christian, a straight white Christian. Donald Trump has given the privilege, the license for these haters to just go out in front of everybody and hate no matter what.
Interesting. Whew. Well, attacking. I think you've laid it all out. I'm not going to challenge your belief system at the moment, but I will say that, you know, there were parts in there that I have questions about. Fair enough.
Fair enough.
All right, let's move it along, ladies and gentlemen.
By the way, you might be a really good Zeus, but I'm an older, good-looking man, so you got competition, bro.
Well, in your kingdom, you can be whatever you want to be. But in this kingdom, the buck stops right there, attacking. Now, don't let your ignorance get you in trouble in the kingdom.
See that remark right there? See that remark right there? Click, click. Attacking sleeps with his mom. See how it goes?
Oh, leave Click Click alone. He's trying to get more followers. We're trying to get him to 1,000 followers so we can
hear from Click Click. I don't have feelings, so I can never be hurt with comments, just so you know.
Oh, God. All right, attacking. Moving on. All right. Thank you so, so much. Ladies and gentlemen, let's keep this party going. Brother Swervin, I've seen you in and out. Hopefully you're doing all great. How are you doing?
I'm doing very well this morning, Zeus. Okay. We have a very nice indication.
Oh, indication, you do?
Indication. Going up today in the beautiful state of New York.
Oh, New York!
New York City is so nice. They named it twice. Check it out one time, won't you, folks? And when you do, come stay at Trump Tower.
Oh, okay? Unfortunately, I would never stay at a Trump Tower. I don't believe in funding terrorists.
Well, that's because you're missing out, Zeus. You've never been a terrorist. No.
Oh, my God. Oh, my goodness.
I think today is something that the American public, you know, the 82 million that voted for Joe Biden, something that we have been waiting on for a very long time. We saw what happened with his charitable organization. He wasn't held personally responsible, but you saw what happened there.
Right.
We saw what happened with the Trump organization, where his CFO, who I think was like number 11 in a long list of felonies and people who went to jail behind this man. And so whether he's found guilty or not, I will give him his due process. That I have no problem with. And I will presume his innocence until a jury of 12 says otherwise. Okay? But right now he is facing the consequences of his actions, which he has never had to face before. And I would remind everyone that Donald Trump is in this situation right now because of Donald Trump. You know, Hillary Clinton, Biden, Obama, none of them told him to pay off Stormy Daniels and Karen McDougal. Nope, none of them told him to do that. That was something that he decided he needed to do. Nobody told him to call Brad Raffensperger and ask for 11,780 votes. No one told him to keep slamming the judge and the prosecutor in the case that he's about to go and be arraigned for. He is where he is at because of him and no one else.
Right.
And right now, he is feeling what it feels like to be a normal American citizen. You get indicted. You do whatever you need to do. And you go through due process just like anyone else. Pure, plain, and simple.
Amen.
And if people can't understand that, you know, yeah, this is the lesser of the crimes that he's been accused of. But you have the documents case. You have the January 6th insurrection.
Right.
You have E. Jean Carroll's case coming up in a couple weeks. You have all these things that are still coming up. This man, it would not surprise me if he is not already in the Guinness Book of World Records for the most sued, legal, litigated person in the world ever. And he's going to go to his grave of litigation. And it's just ridiculous. So if you have a problem with Donald Trump being held accountable, then you're the problem, because they will sit and scream about the country of law and order. And they say, well, what kind of precedents are we setting when we do something like this? What kind of precedents are we setting when we don't do it? What are we saying to the next president of this country? You can do whatever you want to and nobody's going to care.
Yeah.
And let me remind everyone, I just want to remind everyone of this, Zeus, and then I'm going to drop down and get back to my studies here.
Keep it going. Listen, the truth is flowing. Okay. Well,
you're going to love this one. Donald Trump has 34 felony indictments right now. Hunter Biden's laptop has zero.
Oh, that was a low blow, Spurman. That was a low blow.
It's a fact, though, isn't it?
Yeah. Trump Hunter Biden's laptop. I mean, this has to be the most wacky story I've ever heard. And they get on here and they start talking about Hunter Biden's laptop. And they haven't answered my question. What man has a clean laptop?
Well, I you know what? I would have to consider mine to be pretty clean. I ain't going to lie.
Okay. Well, you're one of very few.
I'm sure there's something questionable on there. I just don't know where or what it could be. I'm just saying.
Yeah, it collects all your data. Poor woman, exactly, Angela. They look at Hunter Biden doing dope and partying.
Let me keep going down the scorecard, if I may.
Please go.
34 felony indictments. Joe Biden has zero. 34 felony indictments. Barack Obama has zero. 34 felony indictments. George Bush Jr. has zero. And 34 felony indictments. And Bill Clinton has zero.
Woo!
I guess in that respect, yeah, Donald Trump could be tired of winning.
You have such a dark sense of humor, Swervin. Oh my God. But it's so hilarious.
It is.
He is winning. Some people say that God is using Trump for criminal justice reform. Trump has to go through this so that he can feel the plight of what all these other people who have been wrongfully convicted have felt, so that we can have reform in the criminal justice system. What are your thoughts on that?
Zeus, I tell you like this, and people have heard me say this a dozen times before. Faith is a gift I have yet to receive. Okay. I do believe in higher power. It's the only way I can be comfortable in my own mortality when I shuffle off this mortal coil. But if you believe for one second that Donald Trump is being used by God as some kind of fork to the legal justice system within this country.
Yes.
You already know how jacked up the justice system is in this country.
Right.
When it comes to my melanated brothers and sisters out there, members of the LGBTQI plus community and members of other BIPOC communities, such as indigenous or Latinos. Okay. We already know how unfair the justice system is. But you mean to tell me that God is using Donald Trump, a rich white dude, to show us how unfair the justice system is? I'm sorry, you got to miss me with that all kinds of that garbage.
So you don't buy it?
I'm not buying it. It's too expensive, and they shouldn't be trying to sell it.
Well, there you go, ladies and gentlemen.
It's about as expensive as one of those digital NFT cards. So, dude, let me get back to my studies, brother. I love you, man. Thank you for having me up.
All right. Wow, thank you. Love you too, bro.
We had a great party last night. And, I'm looking forward to this afternoon. I can't wait to see these indictments. So,
they're coming 2:15 p.m. Eastern time. Be there or be square.
Amen, brother. Amen. Don't be a triangle.
No, never. Nope.
Zeus, you take care, brother. I'm going to let you get to your next guest, man. Again.
All right.
Always a pleasure talking to you, my friend.
All right. You too. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, we have a couple of more guests and then we are out of here. Oh, my goodness. Wow. Happy indictment day.
Happy Indaba Day. How are you doing, you handsome truth teller?
Hey, I am doing quite well. And thank you. How are you doing?
I wanted to bring up something that no one's talking about.
Oh.
Where's Melania? Where's Melania? If her husband is innocent, is it not, you know, stand by your man? Where is Melania?
Where would you like to think she's gathering
the rest of her bank accounts and her stuff and getting ready to hit the highway. That's all this is done.
Oh, so you're saying Melania told Trump he's on his own with this.
Well, I mean, why isn't she there?
Would you be by your man if he did these things or he was being accused of these things?
If I felt my heart he was innocent, I would stand by my man.
Mm. So you're saying the fact that Melania, or you're suggesting that the fact that Melania is so quiet on this, it might give credence to this story that, you know, perhaps all of these things he's being accused of might be true.
That's what I'm kind of thinking. I'm loving it, though. I mean, he had to take Eric Trump with him. I mean, good gracious. Out of everyone, Eric.
Maybe
this is going to be a great day, Zeus.
I mean, what is, you got your feelers out here. What is your sense in terms of the feeling, the mood when it comes to the supporters out here?
Well, the mood I get, and I go live and I hear from numerous Trump supporters that, you know, a good 20% of what I have in the boxes thinks there's going to be massive, you know, uprising.
Wow.
If we are to do anything with Trump.
Wow.
That's really sad. It's really sad because of one man, a politician, a billionaire, that they are willing to risk, you know, going to jail, hurting another individual.
Wow. Just
because of this one man. It's scary.
Do you think that deep down inside they actually know that Trump is guilty and they're just kind of using these off the focus behavior things to try to distract from coming to that terrible conclusion that, you know, they've been, you know, caught supporting a criminal?
I believe they believe what he says.
Wow.
They follow what he says, not what the population says, what anybody says, any facts or anything. They believe what he said. He said all media is fake except for Fox. They were great. So what's everything now? Fake news.
Yeah.
So they spouted that. He said the FBI is bad. What happened? They all turned against the FBI. The FBI is behind everything now. And everything has that's not been for him, he's turned his supporters against that.
Wow.
So I believe they believe he's innocent. I really do.
Wow. Really? Even after all of this evidence that's came out, I mean, you still believe that his supporters truly deep down inside believe Trump is innocent?
Well, I'm not going to say all of them, but the ones that buy into everything that he says, because anything he says, they copy and pass that along, you know, fake news, the FBI is bad, everyone's against me, you know. If it's not something good, he don't want to hear about it. It's fake. It's no good. You know, they're against me. Witch hunt. Yeah. All those. It's crazy.
Wow. You know, and it's disturbing to say the least. As we move forward, you know, today they're going to release a lot of information, perhaps what those actual 34 counts are. Do you think when they release the details or, you know, what he's being charged with, do you think it'll start to set in a little more with the Trump supporters?
No, they'll believe their faults and they'll still say the Democrats set it up. I really believe that. They'll still say it's fake. you know, they just going after him. They're making up these charges. That's what's going to be said. And, I mean, we know the truth and we know what's happened. But I do feel that they're going to support him till he is gone.
That's disturbing.
I have a pessimistic view on stuff, so that's why I like to hear from everyone. And I do believe that they will go down with the ship.
Wow. Because, you know, I used to find that there was, you know, I have this bet going, you know, with Snuggles hype, you know, for instance. You know, what are you going to do if he gets indicted? You know, oh, well, then we got to see if he's going to be convicted. And then it's if he gets convicted, we're going to see, you know, what can happen on the appeal, right? And then, if he gets an appeal, then at the end, what, right? And my question is, let's just play this out perfectly. We go through the criminal justice process, and Trump is found to have been guilty. He's found guilty on all of these legal fronts. What would you say we could do as Democrats and Republicans against Trump to help his supporters stop with this blind loyalty at that point? You know, that's kind of what I'm hoping for. I'm hoping that we go through this process together as a country and we get to this point where the evidence is so overwhelming that they have no other choice but to sit back and say, you know what? Trump is a terrible person.
That's a good question, Zeus. I don't know how to, because we've been saying this forever. We've been trying to talk to these people and make them see what they're supporting is just a bad, 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 bad thing. And no one's listened all this time. No one's paid attention. You know, everything is fake. Everything is fake. Trump has told them that we're evil. You know, we're the Democrats, as they call it, you know. Yeah. So they're not going to listen to us. They turned it into a football game. This is the, good gracious, I can't put two teams together. But, you know, it's like two opposing teams that's always, well, let's say Duke and UNC.
Yeah.
You know, you're a diehard UNC fan or you're a diehard Duke fan. And that's how they see it. I honestly see it as we're going to win. We're going to win. They're going to go down with the ship, you know. And it's just scary.
Wow. So the last comment the last question that I have for you, what do you say to the Trump supporters that continue to say that the Democrats are spouting hate?
Oh, that's just not true. No, we know that's not true. We will defend ourselves if we are attacked and from comments that, you know, come into your life. Mm-hmm. And I've got, since I've been doing my lives, the messages I get, and I know you get them too, Zeus.
I get a lot.
I get some horrible messages.
Wow.
I mean, and I've been fair to everyone, but I still, you know, I'll speak my mind on stuff, you know, my point of view on stuff. But yeah, it's bad, and the hate's got to stop. I mean, this is just
is it safe to say that it comes from both sides?
Huh?
Is it safe to say that the hate is coming from both sides, or is it just coming from one side in your opinion?
I think some that's hard. There is hate, people that's just so tired of the lies and the misinformation that they do get hateful on the Democrat side. They really do. They just get fed up with hearing it and, you know, spreading this hate, misinformation, the wrong stuff, and they get frustrated. Republicans will just come out. You'll see somebody enter a room right here and just, it's a hateful comment right away. You know, it's not in defense of something.
Mm-hmm.
It's just hateful. And I think we all need to stop. I mean, we need to sit back and look at what all this is for. One man, a man that has not accomplished really anything in his life for the good. It has accomplished him. It's not done anything for you, me, anyone. He is a regular man that has made some terrible decisions in his life. So, I don't know. I'll be celebrating because finally somebody will be held accountable for what they've done. That's the whole thing. Whether he's convicted, I don't care if he sits down there at Mar-a-Lago. If he is convicted of this and is found to be guilty of this, justice has been served. I want people to be held accountable for their actions. And it's not all right that he just does all this fraud and everyone, you know, and the horrible stuff he's done over his lifetime is just be held
accountable. He's done a lot of horrible things. I must agree. I mean, I'm shocked. I'm shocked each and every single day in terms of how not only the crimes he committed, but I guess we would call it the obstruction that went into the crime as well, right? I mean, here we are. We have Jack Smith piercing the attorney-client privilege. He's getting Trump's own attorneys to disclose what exactly Trump did with those top secret documents. He's getting the staffers to tell us what Trump did with those top secret documents. And outside looking in, you hear stories like when the FBI, when they asked him for the documents, he personally went through those documents, okay, and told himself, I can keep this, they can have that. I can keep this, they can have that. And then gave a statement through his attorneys that he gave them everything back.
Well, now, that's what I don't understand. People standing up for this. Why does he want those documents, Zeus?
Because he's a Russian asset and he's selling it. If you listen to his interview.
Thank you.
If you listen to his interview, he snitched on himself and he said what he's doing with them. They're his. He should have the right to do it. He's using them to make money. And if you really love the United States of America, which is what they brand themselves in their messaging, I don't understand how you can say you love the thank you, Angela. I don't understand how you can say you love the United States of America, but then at the same time are willing to watch Trump break the law and subject the United States to all kinds of risk. I don't get it.
You're absolutely right. I don't get it. I mean, he done illegal stuff. If Biden was to have been found to do that, or any president in the past, Obama, anyone, if they would have found this, they would put him under the jail. It wouldn't be, you know, and everyone would be against it. I mean, if Biden done something, lock him up.
Yep.
If the charges against Biden, that's the difference. We want people to be held accountable for what they do. It doesn't matter who it is. Held accountable. If Biden did something,
yes. I want to answer this question once again, April, because, you know, Trump supporters, oh my gosh, we have more people that want to come up. Ooh, I didn't notice. I thought you were the last.
Yeah, I'm going to have to go back to work in a minute, too.
Oh, okay. But before you go, I just wanted to make sure we touch on this one thing. Do you think the Democrats would defend Biden if Biden was doing what Trump is doing?
Oh, no, 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 no. No, nobody's above the law. We would hold him. We held Clinton accountable.
So can you?
Democrats and I, we held him when he got impeached. We held him accountable.
So I just want to dispel that conspiracy, that myth that's floating around out here that Democrats are protecting Biden and we can't call out Biden. That's misinformation. We will tell if Biden ends up doing any of these things, he can, even if he did a fraction of this,
yeah,
he's getting out of office.
Yes. And what's sad is they keep saying he's doing all this. They're doing all this. We have the charges in the indictments now of Trump. We have no charges, just a Republican investigation. From, you know, the 20, I call them brown shirts sitting over there in the Republican Party. of Biden, but we have no, and the Hunter Biden laptop, I'm so, God, it, when's that going to die down, too?
I agree. When is the Hunter Biden laptop story going to end? I agree. Well, thank you so much, April. I totally appreciate your honesty and your integrity, and keep up the great work hosting those lives, okay? I know it's tough, but you're doing an excellent job. Really. You really are.
Thank you, Jason. Thanks for the support.
No problem. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you. That was April. Oh, my goodness. Oh my gosh. Okay. So, Angela, you said you had 2 minutes. What do you got for us? Yes.
Good morning. How are you?
Good morning. How are you?
I'm fine. Thank you. I'm excited today.
Uh-huh.
I know some people have said it's a dark day. You know that we have to be.
I can't hear you. I think you're fading out in the black.
Oh, can you hear me now?
Yes, I can.
Okay. I'm sorry. Good morning. How are you?
Good morning.
Okay. So I'm excited today. Now, I know some people think this is a dark day, and I agree to an extent that we have to be at this point in our country. But this has to be done. And I think we're finally there. We need to show that this is just, we know, accountability for all. We're finally here. Okay.
Yes.
Now, I don't want to talk about this too much, but I do want to bring up Jack Smith real quick. Jack Smith. Yes, Jack Smith. I know he's haunting them. He's haunting them all. If you're all here, I know you're losing sleep at night because of Jack Smith. Don't even lie. But real quick, on January 6th, okay? Now, I don't want to talk about that too much, but I want to say, I hope Jack Smith gets him on that. That was a tragic day.
Yeah.
That was a very tragic day. We got the documents case. I think we're getting real close on that. Jack is really over. He's overtime. Okay. He's overtime. Let's go, Jack. Okay.
Yes. Now
I know you've got more people to get to. So I have one last thing. Mm-hmm. Is there any way, is Click Click in here? Click Click.
Oh, yeah. Is he here? I know who he is. Yes. He's very strong and powerful, I hear.
Do you think we could get people to follow him so he could get to 1,000 followers?
Click, click, please announce yourself here, wherever you're at. We're trying to get him to 1,000.
I love him. He always has nice comments for all of us in the chat. So I'd really like to see him come up here. I want to see the muscles. I really would like him to come up and say his piece. He has a lot of chirping in the chat. So that's all I wanted to say is if he's in here, everyone give him a follow.
Okay. Yes.
That's it. And let's celebrate this day. I'm sorry.
Thank you.
I got to say. And thank you. And happy celebrating.
I will be celebrating. You know, I'm monitoring the news outlets. And,
yes.
You know what? Let's get it going today, and I hope to see you later at the party.
Oh, you know I'll be there. All right, we'll see you later.
Thank you. Okay, I will see you. Thank you so much.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye-bye. We're moving on. Bye-bye, Lady Blind Wolf. Greetings. How are you?
Good. Getting ready for the tornado we got coming.
Oh, really? Where are you at? Yeah. What state?
Indiana.
Oh, okay. There's a tornado watch today?
Yep.
Oh.
So we're getting ready for that.
Oh. Okay. Well, be safe. Be safe. I don't want you out there getting, you know, into more trouble.
No, I'm just getting everything ready. We're used to this. We grew up having to deal with this. So, but what I want to say is, as a practicing pagan,
mm-hmm.
comparing this man to Jesus Christ is blasphemy. Coming from someone who isn't Christian, Jesus did not force himself on women. Jesus did not walk in on women in the state of undress.
Mm.
Jesus condemned adultery, and that man cheated on all three of his wives. And the person who cheated on their husband supports him. So, but in any event, what I'm trying to say.
Wait a second. Who cheated on her husband?
MGT cheated on her husband.
sin. Righteousness exalts a nation, but sin is a reproach to any nation, ladies and gentlemen. Continue, please, Lady Blind Wolf.
We are what we reflect. And ever since this man reached his stage of adulthood, he has lied, he has manipulated, he has bought his way out of all his mess. He didn't, had he been a grown man and handled his business like an adult, he wouldn't be in the situation that he's in right now. So that's on him. This is stuff that he was doing before he became president. So when it comes to a rich person having to take accountability for the mess they do, heck yeah, I'm going to party today. Heck yeah.
Yeah, you have a point.
And you don't get to sit here and preach morality and try to shove the Bible down people's throats when you don't even follow the rules of your Bible yourself. As a practicing pagan, I believe in karma. So that man is getting what he has reflected.
Do you think it's karma, that it's his downfall is because of, you know, his conduct with women? Do you think that's kind of
his conduct with women, his conduct with the disabled, his conduct with the BIPOC community, with the pagans? I mean, look at the people that support Trump. You have pastors that support Trump that preach from the pulpit. Yeah. I can't wait until it's legal for we can unalive pagans or we can unalive Democrats. You don't see Democrats with signs that say Biden or death at rallies.
Nope. No, you don't.
There we go.
Yeah. We don't. I mean, that to me, that would definitely be extreme and uncalled for.
I mean, the man publicly made fun of disabled people publicly at his own convention.
Yeah, I saw the video.
You know, other countries think that we're ridiculous. They think that we're ridiculous. And I talked to a lady in Ireland, and she couldn't believe that Tennessee law against interracial and interfaith marriage. She could not believe that. Other countries think we're a joke.
Wow. Well, you know, I hear some of the Trump supporters say, America, the other countries are laughing at us.
They are.
Do you think that started because of, you know, Trump and his legal problems, or do you think it started before that?
Here's the thing. At the end of the day, that man is a businessman. He couldn't get anything running in the Democratic Party, so he went to the Republican Party. So he fed to the demographic. Okay, so let me find the people, the bigots, the uneducated, you know, the racists, the people that hate the disabled. Let me market myself to them, because they've been silenced because we've had an intolerance against bigotry and all of that for years. Let me market those people so then I can give them a voice and allow them to speak. He has given these people the megaphone and given them the hammers, so to speak.
Yeah. This is what I hear too. And it definitely is a cause for an alarm, right? I generally, for me, it was something I just sat back and I watched happen. And the mindset was, well, I hope people eventually figure it out and they learn from their ways. And after Trump's presidency, it became crystal clear that sitting back was no longer an option. You have to confront this stuff head on and make sure that you're telling them and challenging them in all ways possible, in terms of making sure what they're saying is being called out, their behavior is being called out, especially when it's inappropriate.
No, they don't even want to hold their own people accountable. They don't hold Jim Olson accountable for what they said about disabled people. They don't want to hold Trump accountable for what he said about disabled people, or Candace Owens for that matter.
You got to start holding your people accountable. If you want things to go get back on track, so to speak, you got to start holding folks accountable and stop this blind allegiance to Trump, because it's not working. Look at it. Your leader is now being indicted and arraigned today. Look at where it got you.
These guys are like little toddlers. I mean, I know you don't have kids, but someone who does. When it's nap time, what does the toddler do? The toddler throws an even bigger tantrum, and that's what we're dealing with now.
Like I said, you're right. Like I said, I don't want to talk about any other topics in the United States of America today other than Trump getting arraigned. I'm not, because what you're saying, it makes me think of that. They don't want to deal with this reality for some strange reason. And it bothers me, but it blows my mind that they don't want to deal with it, but then they will come and tell me that we're going to help Trump win in 2024. You heard that, right?
He's not. It's not, because of the simple fact that, you know, even if he does continue to run, he can still do, because there's nothing that says that a convicted criminal cannot be president. But I think at the end of it, people are so disgusted with him and his behavior. Look at how he handled COVID. We're so disgusted with his behavior, you know, and DeSantis, here we're going to have the same mess with DeSantis. You know, we got to let these guys know we're not going to put up with their crap, you know, but we're so disgusted with his behavior. And if they reelect this man, then all these other countries, and it's going to be a joke. Yeah. And I happen to agree with April about him selling those documents to Russia. And that's probably why they're bringing up this whole S-686 bill. Because if MAGA gets in charge and we have that bill enacted, that's scary.
Oh, it is scary. You're right. Listen, Lady Blind Wolf, you are absolutely right. And I thank you so much for your honesty. Okay, this is what we need to continue to do. Bring honesty out here on TikTok and not misinformation. All right. Now, I do have a couple of more guests, and then Zeus is going to wrap things up. I'm going to sing happy birthday, I know, for Keely. I don't know if she is still here. I know it's been a tough live, but you've made it through. Brother Anthony, greetings. Good morning. How are you?
What's going on with you?
Welcome to Olympus.
You know, it's always a pleasure to be on Olympus.
Oh my God! You notice that it's mighty quiet out here.
Man, it's a bad time, man. Because at the end of the day, Fox and Newsmax and OAN, all these networks can hide the upcoming process to these people, but when these indictments come out, you can't hide that. There are certain things that you cannot hide.
Right.
And I kind of don't want to talk about Trump. I want to talk about, and I don't want to change the topic, but I hardly hear people talk about all the people that have been arrested and convicted in this man's circle. All the campaign managers, the assistant campaign managers, Manafort,
Michael. It started General, with Michael Flynn.
Flynn, Battelle, Bannon.
Roger Stone.
All the attorneys that have gone to prison or are losing their law license behind this guy. Can we talk about the wake of destruction this man has left behind him?
Where do you want to start, though? That's the thing, right? I think it's safe to say working for Trump is almost a bit of a, I don't want to say it, it's an unaliving sentence, so to speak, right? It's not going to end well.
The facts holds true. Everything this man touches crumbles.
It really does.
Anything this man comes in contact with goes under. Whether it's your career, whether it's his businesses, whether it's his airport, I mean his plane company, his vodka company, his casinos. There is nothing there's nothing this man can stand up and say that he's done well in life, except for con people. And again, we talked about it yesterday. We're gonna have some people, even after they've watched and witnessed January 6th. you're still going to have some people that's going to go there and throw their life away. Come on, Zeus, make it make sense. You, the almighty Zeus, come on, make it make sense. Can we get some clarity up here?
As far as I am concerned, people who do this believe that they're doing the right thing, right? And this mm-hmm. is kind of the mindset that we're dealing with. A lot of his supporters believe the right thing is to do exactly what you said. It is to label, you gotta start creating images of who you think is the enemy. This is how warfare works, right? So he's done a great job of marketing to them who he wants them to focus on as the enemy, the radical left. And as a great, you know, puppeteer, he's able to put things into their world that make them really believe it's the Democrats doing these things. And when you challenge them and you try to push back on them and say, okay, so you do know that Trump committed those crimes. He slept with Stormy Daniels. Yes. Now let's just let that sink in for a second. What did that have to do with the Democrats? Well, everybody sleeps with someone. Okay, here we go down that rabbit hole, right? Okay, so we all did it. Okay, so why do you think he's kind of getting in trouble? What about the money that was paid? Does everybody do that? Well, we all have paid. Okay, let's unpack this. Have you ever created a business? Have you ever paid someone by creating a business and falsifying documents?
To hide that you pay. Come on, man.
Have you done that? I know what it's like to spend a couple of dollars on something. I know, I get that. But I would never go as far as to try to cover it up like this. At a certain point in my schemes, I just had to admit, yeah, I lied. I'm a dog.
That part, Zeus. Accountability.
I'm a dog. Yeah, okay. Your wife found out. She filed a divorce.
You gotta swallow it.
Yeah, there's rehabilitation programs you can go in to help you with their addiction, if that's what it was, and we can all move on. But I have never, you know, they say no other American president has been subjected to the law like this, and it's like no other American president has done these things. I've never seen someone commit so many crimes. And like you said earlier, everybody around him is going to jail. In my mind, either you're a criminal or you're a snitch. Because why does everybody got to go to jail around you?
Facts. Right? Hey, facts.
Everybody's going to jail except you.
See, that went over a lot of people's heads, Zeus. That went over a lot of people's heads, Zeus. You know, either you're a criminal and you're snitching.
Yeah.
Or it ain't no way around it. It ain't no way around it.
So, for a second, here's my honest truth about that. For a second, I did think to myself, Trump probably is snitching on all these people to save his rear end, and that's why everyone around him goes to jail. I really did think that, and that's why I never thought Trump would ever get caught. I thought he was an inside agent working for the Department of Justice, and that, you know, he was draining the metaphorical swamp by making sure you knew everyone around him was guilty. But where we are now has changed that. I think he is possibly a snitch and a criminal now.
I think it's more along the lines of to protect this guy and to be in his circle allows for criminality. And he doesn't have to touch a lot of things. And we all you know where we're from. You know when you don't have to touch things, it makes it harder for them to get you.
Correct.
So what the problem is finna be, and you know once they get up that line to where you are, 9 times out of 10, that guy tells on everybody. We haven't seen anything yet. We haven't seen anything yet. Wait till Jack gets to the point, because he's digging. Wait till he gets to lining up Marjorie Taylor Greene and Lauren Boebert and all. It's gonna be a lot of shakeup. It's gonna be a lot of shakeup.
I mean, and to those who think they say Jack ain't, they go Jack who or Jack ain't gonna do whatever they think. I'm like, you must not have been aware of how the Department of Justice has brought down powerful people before. You must not have seen the aggressive tactics that they got. They can make anybody flip.
And I know this is your gym time, so I'm gonna say one more thing. I'm gonna piggyback off the not the last caller, but the caller before that. Yes. And everybody in here, find click click. And we're gonna follow click click so that we can finally, after a year and a half, see click click in that little boy's shirt that he got on. We can finally see click click in that little boy's shirt he got on.
Oh God!
And appreciate the steroid usage he's used thus far. You know.
Oh my God! He has a lot good to say. I'll give it to him. He's been following me for a long time, and I'll give it to him. He's consistent about what he believes in. But I'm curious what he sounds like. I'm curious about what he has to say, and for that, I've given him the follow for sure.
Hey Zeus, but we all know what long-term steroid use does to you, right?
Yes.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen. Oh my God! He's shooting blanks.
Have a good one, bro.
All right, you too. He's shooting blanks, ladies and gentlemen. Wow! Oh my goodness! Oh, we have Brother Greg in the building. Oh my gosh! Happy Indictment Day! Greetings, Greg. How are you? Here.
I'm sorry, Zeus. I need a second. I need a second. Give me a second.
Yazzy, thank you. Uh-oh. Oh, it's a quiet day out here on these murky TikTok streets, ladies and gentlemen. It's a quiet, quiet day. Like I said, be not alarmed. This is definitely evidence that the message is getting out there. Oh my goodness. Oh my gosh, Yazzy. Okay, yes, please. Do not miss your Zoom meeting. Work is important. Make that money. Where are the birds at, Angela? Well, you know, like I said yesterday, this is tough. This is tough. You know, they want to debate. They want to debate things like, you know, the Second Amendment, abortion. What else do they want to? Transgender issues, things they're not experts in. They want to talk about that instead of Trump today. Yes, Greg.
All right, Zeus. Okay.
Yes.
So very, very busy today at work. That's why I haven't been able to come in. So this is just what I want to say. We were talking about the felony counts.
Right.
They're saying 34 felony counts. So what that would mean is, if we're just doing math, that would mean 11 checks times 3 plus 1 conspiracy. So that would mean, if we're looking at that, that would mean the case goes beyond Stormy, and it likely includes Karen McDougal, David Pecker, AMI, and Elliot Brody, who was a guy that was a GOP operative that was involved with these hush money payments. So if I was making predictions, that's what I would be talking about today. The playmate, Shira Bacard. She was the one that had the affair with a major fundraiser, which was the Elliot Brody.
Mm.
And so, my interest is if they got them all intertwined together. Mm. So we might be hearing about a lot of those names today, which is interesting.
It's I'm telling you. Do you think Trump is going to take accountability for this once this information is disclosed? I mean, or is he going to do a one hell of a cleanup job trying to sweep this under the rug? Because I don't know how he can spin this.
It's entirely possible, but the issue is that what we're looking at here is we're just looking at a potential, just a very interesting, intertwined kind of connection. And if they get him with falsifying business records in the second degree, that is when they're able to say that there was a intent to defraud. Mm-hmm. So the law is kind of interesting. It says,
well, they're claiming the felony is because it's the covering up of a crime, right? Using a crime to cover up another crime.
Correct. And so I'm interested to see if they get that one as well. But there, those three names that I mentioned, McDougal, yes. Pecker, AMI, and also Elliot Brody, who was the GOP operative. I'm wondering if they're also intertwined in this.
I think we're going to find that out very soon. I wouldn't be surprised. It's
quite possible, but I don't know for sure. But it would be interesting because, again, what Shea said is correct, because the Southern District of New York did not charge Trump with a campaign finance fraud because Barr intervened. Right. Now, one would say, would the Attorney General charge Barr with obstruction of justice? But I doubt that would happen. But it would be funny. It would good be funny.
Belinda, nice to see you. They could justify that, whatever Barr was doing.
If they can prove it on a state level, I guess.
Yeah. You know. But they're going to just say it was within the scope of his duties as, you know, AG. I know how these things work. I don't think Barr is in as much trouble in terms of not, you know, putting that pressure on them to not pursue the charges.
Yeah. So that's kind of just where everything lies right now. There's not a lot of real more information than that, but that is what is, you know, speculation at this point. The 34 felony counts with the checks, 11 times 3. Someone in the comments said they kicked MTG out of New York City, which is interesting. I didn't see that.
Well, I'm going to have to see that. You know, MTG and the mayor of New York definitely are sparring in terms of words. But we gotta tune in, ladies and gentlemen.
I've been a busy bee this morning, you know, selling policies. We're killing it, Zeus.
Thank you.
Biden's economy, man. He's really helping.
Well, you know what, Brother Greg, I appreciate you, but you know it is time for Zeus to run.
I appreciate you letting me up here and.
I always appreciate you and all of our friends checking in. It's a good time when we all can get together and discuss these kind of things, you know.
It's well, what we've been indicated, okay. So true.
Okay. Oh my gosh. Right. Well, listen. Thank you all so much. Now, Keely, are you here? I did tell you I was going to sing you happy birthday. I don't know if you're still here, but Zeus will sing happy birthday, okay, if you're still here. If not, ladies and gentlemen, I must depart and go to work out at the gym. All of you, please be safe out there, okay? I know it's a tough time right now for a lot of people. If I can televise it, I will, Christina. I definitely will. I know it's a tough time for a lot of people, but we will make it through this. I truly do believe... this step is needed in order for this country to heal and move forward. I really do. Count it all joy, ladies and gentlemen. This is what accountability looks like. There are times in life where you are going to go through things that will challenge everything you believe in. And my hope is that you learn from that experience and use it to make yourself a better person. I kid you not, ladies and gentlemen. I am only here because of that same belief system. If you don't do if you do not take accountability for your behavior, it will eventually catch up to you, and it will pop up in ways you never thought. Take my word from it. All right, ladies and gentlemen, you know the deal. We got to get out of here, and I will see you later. 2:15 Eastern time. Be there or be square.
They don't like it, but it's the truth. Take care, ladies and gentlemen. And thank you all for tuning in. What a great show!
Now I move when I'm walking like this. This is how I sound when I'm talking like this. This is how I stare when I'm looking like this. I like to act a fool when I'm moving like this. Don't be playing with my mood when I'm moving like this.
Triple H is back.
I look like this. Thunder in the sky like you up like this. I make my own rules, I'm a god, call me Zeus. I'm flyer than an eagle, I got red on me. Took the long time to get here and I'm feeling brand new. If you living like a bum, get away from me. Boy, I got money on my mind.
Soundtaste audio. I like your DJ, brother. I saw him.
Mix all in the mix, I put a
band in the new ways in the comment section.
When you playing with the gods and you playing with
the
gods. Let's go! Hey, little mama, let me play with your caboose. I know the ladies love me cause I'm sweet like a tooth. Player hating on the gods, boy, you're such a douche. I tried to be patient, but you had to light my fuse. I'm catching all these snakes like a mongoose.
Yes, yes, ladies love me, yeah,
I'm the one that they choose. You know I'm so handsome, that's why they call
me. Have a good day, hey,
this is how I move when I'm walking like Zeus. This is how I sound when I'm talking like Zeus. This is how I stare when I'm looking like Zeus.
They don't like it.
Like Zeus. Thunder in the sky like you up like Zeus. I make my own rules. I'm a god, call me Zeus. I'm hotter than Hades and I'm burning down the roof. You say you want it back, but I'm living proof. I've been waiting for this moment. Now I gotta choose. If you play around with love, then you guarantee to lose.
I didn't make the game of rules, so don't play me like a fool.
If you can't swim, don't be in the pool. Even though I'm hot, people telling me be cool. I'm just sitting on my throne.
Let's
while you
go,
looking
let's
like
go.
Hey, little mama, let me play with your caboose. I know the ladies love me cause I'm sweet like a tooth. They hating on the gods, boy, you're such a douche. Try to be patient, but you act have
to like nice to see
catching all these snakes like a mongoose. These ladies love me, yeah, I'm the one that they choose. You know I'm so handsome, that's why they call me Zeus. This is how I move when I'm walking like Zeus. This is how I sound when I'm talking like Zeus.
Welcome,
this is how I stare when I'm looking like Zeus. I like to act a fool when I'm moving like Zeus. Don't be playing with my mood when I'm moving like
it
Zeus.
Really was.
Thinking that you're cool till I pull up like Zeus. Thunder in the sky like you up like Zeus. I make my own rules, I'm a god, call me Zeus.
Yeah, you know about me.
Take care, right, ladies and gentlemen. We have an exciting day.
I'm bringing down the roof.
We have an exciting day. We really do. Freedom Rider.
Long Green on the beat. You better call the truth, ladies and gentlemen. I can dance on the box in the jungle like a kangaroo. Don't get caught flipping the woods, you be dead like a
Lindsay on the beat like Zeus.
Like Zeus.
Yeah,
you're about three. Take care, ladies and gentlemen.
I'm out of here. Perfect.